A very good morning of the students of class 8. Today we will study and learn about the age of revolution. Revolution means andolan, andolan ka samay. Here we will study revolution in America and France. France and America mein jo इंडिपेंडेंस के लिए आंदोलन हुआ उसके बारे में हम लोग यहाँ पढ़ेंगे. दी लेट 18th सेंचुरी वॉज ए पीरियड ऑफ रिवोल्यूशन इन अमेरिका एंड फ्रांस. दी अमेरिकन रिवोल्यूशन 1775 to 83 वॉज ए मोमेंटस हिस्टोरिकल माइलस्टोन विच inspired the people of other countries to overthrow their colonial masters and paved the path to democracy and self-government. Means during America mein jo andolan hua 1775 to 1783 ye jo hua आंदोलन अपना इंडिपेंडेंस होने के लिए. द फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन 1789 to 99 वॉज अनदर पाथ ब्रेकिंग हिस्टोरिकल लैंडमार्क. इट वॉज पॉलिटिकल, सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक इन नेचर एंड एंडेड द रूल ऑफ हेरिडेटरी किंग्स. It also strengthened and empowered the middle class, gave hope to the poor and downtrodden people of society, and introduced democratic ideas and deals in France. Means the France mein revolution andolan hua 1789 se 99 ke beech mein, to ek historical landmark bana. ना केवल पॉलिटिकल, सोशल बट इकोनॉमिक भी हुआ एंड लेटर ऑन एंड ऑफ द रूल ऑफ हेरिडेटरी किंग्स. मतलब राजाओं का जो शासन था, जो वंशगत चल रही थी, वह समाप्त हो गई और फ्रांस में डेमोक्रेटिक आइडिया का उत्पत्ति हुई. नाउ वी विल रीड मोर अबाउट द अमेरिकन वार ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस. मीन्स अमेरिका में स्वतंत्रता प्राप्त करने के लिए जो वार लड़ी गई उनके बारे में हम लोग पढ़ेंगे. द अमेरिकन वार ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस और द अमेरिकन रिवोल्यूशन वॉज द फर्स्ट ऑर्गेनाइज पोलिटिकल रिवोल्यूशन इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इन विच people asserted their right to rule themselves. It led to first means America mein jo war of independence hua usi ko hum log American revolution bhi kehte hain, kyunki America ek colony bana hua tha Britain ka, to Britain se wo swatantrata prapt karna chahti thi, jiske karan yah andolan shuru hua America mein. First the birth of the United States of America as a nation. Second, the end of autocratic rule. And third, the establishment of a democratic form of government. Means America में जो 13 colonies जो थे, ये हम लोग यहाँ येलो कलर में जो देखते हैं, ये 13 colonies जो था ये अमेरिका ब्रिटेन का कॉलोनी था. इस कॉलोनी से उनको बहुत फ़ायदा होती थी, शासन यहाँ ब्रिटेन का होता था और यहाँ अमेरिकन लोग जो यहाँ थे, जो ब्रिटेन से आके यहाँ लिबरल माइंडेड पीपल आके बसे थे, वे लोग पूरा का पूरा उनका शासन से त्रस्त थे. जैसे हमारे देश में, भारत देश में ब्रिटेन के शासन से त्रस्त था, उसी प्रकार अमेरिकन ये 13 कॉलोनीज ऑल्सो वेयर द fed up with the rule of British. Now we'll see about the causes of the American War of Independence. What was the cause? क्या कारण था, क्या फैक्टर था जिसके कारण से ये अमेरिका में इंडिपेंडेंस के लिए वार हुआ. The discovery of the American continent, the new world means America, was followed by the establishment of permanent European settlement in the 16th century. बाय द मिडिल ऑफ द 18th सेंचुरी 13 ब्रिटिश कॉलोनीज हैड बीन इस्टेब्लिश अलोंग द ईस्ट कोस्ट ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका। मतलब नॉर्थ अमेरिका ये जो सी कोस्ट ऑफ अटलांटिक ओशन के पास हम लोग 13 कॉलोनीज देखते हैं, ये सेटलमेंट अमेरिका का था जो ब्रिटेन के लोग आके यहाँ पर बस गए थे। द फर्स्ट कोज वॉज द रिजिड कंट्रोल ओवर इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज, मीन्स ये जो पॉलिसीज था बहुत पावरफुल था, ये ब्रिटेन से रूल किया जाता था। दीज कॉलोनीज मीन्स 13 कॉलोनीज वेर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट विच गेव देम कंसिडरेबल लिबर्टी टू मैनेज लोकल अफेयर्स बट केप्ट ए टाइट कंट्रोल ऑन इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज। द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंग्लैंड बिलीव दैट द कॉलोनीज एग्जिस्टेड फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द मदर कंट्री। मदर कंट्री मीन्स ब्रिटेन, द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट और इंग्लैंड सीमिंग दैट दैट दीज कॉलोनीज आर फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ देयर मदरलैंड मदर कंट्री इंग्लैंड। दिस वॉज ग्रेटली रिसेंटेड बाय द कॉलोनिस्ट हु वेयर इंडिपेंडेंट माइंडेड ब्रिटिशर्स हु हैड लेफ्ट देयर होम्स इन इंग्लैंड and settled in the new world in search of freedom and a better life. By the mid-18th century, these 13 colonies had developed into prosperous agricultural settlement mainly in north, in the south with small but flourishing industries in the north and a thriving overseas trade. Means the North America, this part that industries had in settlement took place, and the South America, the agricultural, the settlement took place. Second, we'll learn about the unjust and exploitative administration. Each colony had its own assembly elected by the people of the colony, but the governor of the colony was appointed by the British government. Means प्रत्येक in the all 13 colonies अपना अपना assembly था, but उन governor एक हुआ करते थे जो appointed by the British government. The governor was not answerable to the assembly. He governed the colony in the interest of Great Britain, the mother country, and not colonist. This causes great resentment among the American settlers who worked very hard but could not enjoy the fruits of their labor, because they were working very hard and giving a tax, heavy taxes to the British, because Britain was sending their representatives as a governor. They were interest of the Great Britain settling down into the America, and these all 13 colonies, and then they were taking heavy tax from the American. Now third cause, heavy taxation and restrictions on business and commerce. The British government collected heavy taxes from them and imposed many restrictions on their business and commerce. These restrictions greatly hampered the economic development of these colonies. The fourth, social and cultural differences. Socially and culturally, the American colonists were different from the British. The colonists were simple and liberal, unlike the British, the Puritans, who were rigid and conservative. Over the years, the colonists had developed a distinct identity of their own, an American identity that aspired for freedom to grow and develop as a separate independent nation. Next point, no representation in the British Parliament. As the mother country Britain expected, obedience matter came to head with when colonists demanded the right to have a say to matter affecting them. द कॉलोनिस्ट आर्ग्यूड दैट द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट हैड नो राइट टू टैक्स ऑन द कॉलोनिस्ट सिंस दे हैड नो रिप्रेजेंटेटिव इन द पार्लियामेंट. नो टैक्सेशन विदाउट रिप्रेजेंटेशन बिकेम द क्लरियन कॉल ए क्लियर मैसेज ऑफ द कॉलोनिस्ट. मीन्स द अमेरिकन्स दे स्टार्टेड टू आर्ग्यू विद द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट दैट देर आर नो रिप्रेजेंटेशन फ्रॉम द कॉलोनिस्ट कॉलोनिस्ट ऑफ अमेरिका. देन वाई दैट ब्रिटेन इम्पोज tax on the these colonies. So they had given a slogan, no taxation without representation. Next point, influencing of European philosophers. The American revolutionaries were greatly influenced by the ideas of European philosophers like Locke, Voltaire and Rousseau, who inspired them to fight for liberty. Next point, demand for total freedom. The demand for the representation in the British Parliament gave way to the demand for total freedom from the British rule. The colonists began to assert their right to sovereign authority and argued that the right to govern should be based on the consent of the governed. The unjust oppression and exploitative British government had forfeited its right to govern the American colonists and must therefore be overthrown. Means they demanded about the total freedom, means independence, so that the America, the 13 colonies can be became a sovereign authority and they should not be ruled by the British government. Now next point, we will read about that the Boston Tea Party. Boston Tea Party. Tea Party means don't understand anywhere you are sitting in the cafe or in the party and having a tea. No, it is a Boston Tea Party. Boston is a city of the American. There was some incident had took place or taken place. The conflict eventually led to an open revolt of the colonies. The revolt known as the American War of Independence was sparked off by an incident known as the Boston Tea Party. In 1773, a group of colonists disguised a Native American raided British ships in Boston Harbor and threw 340 crates of tea into the sea. This incident was a protest against the new taxes, including a tax on tea imposed on the colonies. The Boston Tea Party was seen as an act of open defiance of the colonists against British authority. Means Boston Tea Party, thus a group of colonists disguised and raided on the British ship and thrown on the Boston Harbor, thrown the around 340 crates of tea into the sea. This is known as a Boston Tea Party. So students, read it for better understanding. Thank you.